Okay, this spreadsheet is supposed to be the one to motivate notions of risk aversion, and we're going to do a little experiment here to try to convey ideas about risk aversion. Before I do that, let me give you a little tour of the rest of what's on the spreadsheet. So if you scroll to the right here a bit, there are notes that are embedded, and there's a link to a PDF file outside the spreadsheet which has the same content, so you can get it either way. I strongly encourage you to read this stuff. It's mostly familiar stuff about the math of probability, but there's also a little bit about the economic interpretation of probability and some stuff at the end about the math of expected utility that maybe you haven't seen before, so you should take a look to get comfortable with that. A little further to the right, I want to show that we're doing experiments here. So we're using Excel's random number generator to flip coins, and the outcome of the coin is here, and we're looking at when does the first head come up. In this case, heads came up the very first flip, but if we do the experiment over and over again, we'll get heads coming up in a different place. So now let's go back to here. We're going to look at this famous gamble that's been proposed. The gamble pays off an amount of money depending upon when the first head comes up. If it comes up the first time, you get $1. If it comes up the second time, you get $2. If it comes up the third time, you get $4. In general, if you get n tails in a row and then a head, you get 2 to the n dollars. So let's do several rounds of this. Here came up the second time. Here came up the first time. Here came up the second time. Let's see if we can get one which has a lot of heads in a row. There we get in 16. That's pretty good, $16. Let's see if we can get some even higher than that. Mostly we're getting low payoffs, but let's see if we can get a big one. I'm going to rapid click through here and see if we can see a big one through the rapid clicking, and still not a real big one. Oh, there's a pretty good one. All right, so let's stay with that. Now I want to scroll down a little bit more and look at the math of this. If you compute the expected payout of this gamble, the probability of getting n tails in a row and then a head is 1 over 2 to the n plus 1. So the payoffs that you're getting, $1 with probability a half, $2 with probability a quarter, $4 with probability an eighth, etc. The expected payoff, therefore, is 50 cents plus 50 cents plus 50 cents ad infinitum. The expected payoff is infinity. In other words, most of the time you're going to get a low payoff, but on occasion you'll get a real big one. The expected dollar payoff is a lot. How much would you pay for this? Probably a couple of dollars, maybe not that much more. This is a very famous gamble called the St. Petersburg Paradox. It was invented by Daniel Bernoulli, who was trying to show that gambles are not the same as having this expected dollar value for certain. Bernoulli resolved the paradox, that is, the gamble itself has an infinite expected value, but people aren't going to be willing to pay for that, by assuming that people get a certain utility from the gamble. He assumed it was something like the square root of x. If you do use the square root of x as the utility, the expected dollar value of the expected utility of the gamble is the equivalent of getting less than $3 for certain. So there you have it.